Recht op Lucht are citizens of Antwerp. We are a group of people who strive for a healthy city. And since 2021, we exist. And from that moment, we start measuring the air quality in 12 street canyons in the city. And we try to put pressure on the air quality and mobility policy of our city. It's difficult to relate the effective impact of air quality on health, but for Antwerp there are data which says that there are about 400 premature deaths because of particulate matter, plus 300 premature deaths because of NO2. And if you compare that with COVID in 2020, there were a little less than 600 deaths for the city of Antwerp. So the air pollution causes more deaths every year than COVID did in 2020.
The main sources of air pollution are, I would say, threefold. First of all, you have the mobility issue. It's not only persons, but also transport for industry, so logistics. A second branch are the industry. Around Antwerp, there are a lot of enterprises, and of course the harbor. With the chemical node, a lot of pollution is coming from this industry. And then, of course, in Flanders, it's agriculture.
Antwerp is one of the largest European harbors and a major transport hub at the European level. There was a study in the Lancet in 2021 that ranked Antwerp as one of the cities with the highest mortality related to nitrogen dioxide. However, the study was based on data from 2015. Air quality levels in the city have decreased very importantly. If you look at nitrogen dioxide concentrations, for instance, they have decreased with 30 to 40% in almost all of the measuring stations in Antwerp between 2015 and 2020.
We think the mobility policy has a lot to do with air quality because the pollution of transport and cars is a big part in the overall air quality pollution. For example, NO2, more than 60% of the pollution comes from car traffic. And the car traffic is in Belgium kind of promoted. People are pushed into their cars because of fiscal rules. The last months before this summer, there has been four projects, for example, one big development nearby the central train station with 1,600 underground parking lots. And of course, every place in Antwerp should be reachable by car, if necessary. But the transport by bike and by pedestrian should be the first choice. It's really easy and low cost to implement.
The city of Antwerp takes various air quality measures with a focus on five priority areas. The first one is a reduction of motorized traffic. Our second goal is to reduce the emissions of the remaining cars and vans. And therefore, the city introduced a low emission zone in 2017, the first one in Belgium. Third, we are making a transition towards more sustainable domestic heating. For instance, through rolling out a very extensive district heating network in the city that will allow many citizens in Antwerp to heat their house with industrial waste heat in the future. Fourth, the city is innovating towards more circular and emission-free industry. Finally, the city also closely works together with schools in raising awareness on air quality. Despite the positive evolution, it's very important that we continue our efforts to keep the air pollution concentrations down, because elsewhere in Flanders and in many parts of Europe, we still do not respect the guidelines of the World Health Organization, which means that many citizens in Antwerp still suffer the negative impact of the current air quality conditions, and especially children, elderly and vulnerable people.